You can design the oscillator using simple transistor, or you can design the oscillator using operational amplifier. So here in this lecture we will discuss the basic introduction of an oscillator. So what is oscillator? An oscillator is an electronic device which is used to generate an AC waveform. So in case of oscillator, the output will be in form of sine wave, or we can say AC waveform. It is also called waveform generator or signal generator, which incorporates both active and passive element. So when we are using the operational amplifier, then in that circuitry the operational amplifier is the active element, and the other components like resistor, capacitor, these are the passive element. And here the oscillator using op amp provides better gain and stability, so we can consider the operational amplifier circuitry to design the oscillator. They are used in radio, TV, computers and communications, etc. In many applications such as generation of clock pulses and digital electronics, signal carriers for information transmission and storage, sweep signals for information display, test signals for automatic test and measurement, and audio signals for electronic music and speech synthesis. In these applications, the signal need to be generated within the system itself. So in case of oscillator, we can design the oscillator using op-amp IC also. So this is the principle of operation. An oscillator uses the positive feedback which generates the output signal without input signal. So here in the circuitry, this one is the amplifier circuit and this is the feedback circuit. So here the amplifier, in case of amplifier, A is the voltage gain and here the beta is the feedback gain. So this amplifier circuitry in case of oscillator provide 180 degree phase shift, and this feedback circuit also provide the 180 degree phase shift. So in case of oscillator, the total phase shift required around the loop will be 360 degree, or 0 degree is also required. So here the voltage gain of the amplifier also increases with the increase in the amount of positive feedback. It is a feedback amplifier in which a fraction of output is feedback to the input via a feedback circuit. So this is the block diagram of an oscillator. So here no need for the input voltage in the oscillator circuitry, and the output is directly connected to the input like this. And here this is the feedback circuit. So this is the block diagram of an oscillator, and the output will be in form of sine wave. So here according to that figure, there is no input signal is applied, then Vin is equal to 0. From the block diagram, that is so here the Vd is equal to Vf plus Vin. Here this is the output V naught, this is the amplifier output, that is V naught. This is the Vf feedback voltage, Vf, and Vd is the difference voltage. So here the Vd is equal to Vf plus Vin. This is Vd, so this is equal to Vf plus Vin. And now because in circuitry no input voltage is required, so Vin is equal to 0. And now this Vd is equal to Vf, so here Vin is equal to 0, so this is Vd equal to Vf. In block diagram, V naught is equal to A into Vd, because we know that the output voltage is always equal to A into Vd. Here A is the voltage gain and Vd is the differential voltage. And here the feedback voltage is equal to beta into V naught. So here the overall gain is equal to V naught upon V in is equal to, here V naught is equal to A into Vt according to equation 2. So we can put this V naught is equal to A into Vt, and here V in, this is equal to Vt minus Vf according to this equation 1. Here this V in will be equal to Vt minus Vf. So here this V in is equal to Vt minus Vf, and here that is also equal to Vt minus Vf is also equal to beta into V naught. So here we can put this. So here Vt minus beta into V naught. Now calculate, this is equal to A into Vt, and this is Vt minus beta and into V naught. So here V naught is equal to Vf upon beta. So here this is beta, and here V naught is equal to, this is also equal to A into Vt. So here V naught is also equal to A into Vt. So here V naught upon V in is equal to A upon 1 minus A beta. Now an oscillator does not require any external input signal to produce the output waveform. Therefore, the input voltage is equal to zero, but the output is not equal to zero. So here the output voltage is not equal to zero. This implies that V naught upon V in is equal to A upon 1 minus A beta, because here this V naught upon V in is equal to A upon 1 minus A beta. So here this is equal to, so now V in is equal to 0 here. So this V naught upon 0 equal to A into 1 minus A beta. Now solve this equation, and this is equal to 0, and this is equal to V naught into 1 minus A beta. So here after solving this equation, this A beta is equal to 1. So there are two conditions. Here the first one condition is the magnitude of the loop gain A beta must be at least 1 in case of oscillations. So basic requirement for oscillations are the loop gain A beta, magnitude of the loop gain A beta must be at least 1. So here A beta is equal to 1, and the polar form is 0 degree or 360 degree. So here the total phase shift of the loop gain A beta must be equal to 0 degree or 360 degree. So in case of oscillator, there is a total phase shift will be required, that is 0 degree or 360 degree. So these are the two conditions, and these conditions are called sustained oscillation condition. So in this oscillator, if the amplifier causes a phase shift of 180 degree, the feedback circuit must provide an additional phase shift of 180 degree so that the total phase shift around the loop is 360 degree. So there are these are the types of oscillator. So the types are that is basically classified into the sinusoidal oscillator, or we can say harmonic oscillator, and the second one is non-sinusoidal oscillator or relaxation oscillator. So in case of sinusoidal oscillator, the oscillators generates the waveform which are sinusoidal in nature are called sinusoidal oscillator. These oscillators can provide output at frequencies ranging from 20 hertz to gigahertz. Such oscillators are classified as LC oscillator. LC oscillator means this oscillator uses a tuned circuit which is consisting of inductor L and the capacitor C. They are used to generate high frequency signals. They are also known as radio frequency oscillators. These oscillators are such as Hartley and Kolpit oscillator. And the second one is RC oscillators. RC oscillators require the resistor or capacitor in the circuitry. So we can say the RC oscillator. They are used to generate low or audio frequency signals. They are also known as audio frequency oscillators. And these oscillators are such as phase shift oscillator and Van Brisch oscillator. So these are the audio frequency oscillators. The applications of an oscillator are, these oscillator basically used in many applications. So these are some applications. The first one is used in quartz watches. Used in various audio systems and video systems, used in various radio, TV, computers and communication system also, used in metal detectors, stun guns, inverters, ultrasonic and radio frequency applications or other communication, used to generate clock pulses for microprocessors and microcontrollers, used in alarms and buzzes, used to operate decorative lights such as dancing lights, etc. So we can use these oscillators for various applications. Thank you for watching.